Okay, what if you go bishop h3 first?
Yeah, well,
so that's another story.
But I missed it. Oh, and I didn't really. Oh, I saw rook e6 when he played knight c6, but somehow I was thinking, oh, it can't be worse for me. I don't know why, but maybe it's not. Is it? Or it's already worse.
I prefer black.
Okay. No, because I was also thinking I have this move. Because if you take the rook, I have the check. But I realized probably king b8 with idea rook e1 check and attacking the rook. Probably it gives back advantage.
And the other move right now is play rook takes b7,
yeah.
Queen c5, rook e7.
Yes, sure.
Well, the pawns are equal and these ones are not so dangerous yet. Maybe it's playable.
Probably it was, but it looked quite bad to me with the, well, because these pawns they are solid as just extremely solid, and once the d-pawn gets here, going to resign. So I was hoping that after knight e6 fe my position is bad enough that Jan stopped preparing. So I was thinking I still maybe can make a game out of it. Yeah, this I played a little bit risky move. Rook a4. This is a turn.
Yeah, the rook can go anywhere on the a-file.
Yeah, but I thought that it made sense to try some bluff attacking ideas in order to complicate it as much as possible.
And here, for the first time, I started to think a bit. I remember that d4 and queen c5 were both attractive options, and I decided to go for the most solid one, which is queen c5, preparing knight d4.
Yeah, this is very...
And just in case, defending the rook.
Yeah, it's very unpleasant when black plays solid here, because white doesn't have much to do. I mean, it's possible to push the pawn, but somehow I cannot believe it's quick enough to compete with these ones. So I was just trying to make up something. Let's check, because now he has two options.
Yeah, I wasted some time trying to choose.
Quite some time, yeah.
And I guess it doesn't really matter so much.
Yeah, I guess both are possible.
Yeah. Yeah, I was just in case defending the pieces over here.
And somehow I didn't really think about the move, but it doesn't matter anymore, it's an option. And now I played bishop f1 here.
Yeah.
Yeah, because, well, I realized probably I'm lost, so I thought I'll try to provoke knight f3 check and the d4 ideas so I can get some counter chances, and perhaps I'll be lucky to have some counterplay and then maybe trick him somewhere.
And I was glad that, bishop leaves the long diagonal, and I thought it was time to bring my own bishop into play.
Yeah, here I realized that probably it didn't make sense. But then I thought, I didn't have too much time to think anyway, and I thought I'll just put bishop on c4, because this is always the move I want to play, but I think here c2.
Yeah, you're not...
Yeah, and now if bishop c4, then d3, I think. Yeah, well, it doesn't look... and this just rolls down. Yeah, to be honest, when I played the move, I just... I think I missed something. I missed touch knight e8. I was thinking I have queen b8 maybe, but then he has queen c6, so I was thinking after knight e5 I'll have to resign sooner or later.
And I was a bit worried about the rook e8 for some strange reasons.
Yes, and I then, after a young thought for maybe almost an hour, I then thought probably the reason he doesn't play the move immediately is bishop a6.
Yeah.
And I was trying to find something tricky, but rook e8 I actually still saved my attention. But apparently bishop a6 is not a bad move.
Yeah. Once white can exchange this bishop, the king starts to feel a bit unsafe.
Yeah, and this one starts to feel safer, on contrary. And if you, the idea is that if you play a move like this, I'm going to ignore the bishop probably, and for example, a position like this one, it's not clear whose king is more danger.
Although black at any moment can make a bishop, so
of course.
Things are safe.
Yeah, but I wasn't...
I actually expected to win quite easily. But
yeah, me too. Expected Jan to win quite easily.
Yeah.
And then I thought, well, perhaps it's not easy.
Okay, I decided to block the rook for the moment.
Yeah, we heard, by the way, that computer suggests you move like d3.
Yeah.
And I think I missed... I saw the move existing, but I missed the...
I was checking it, but it seemed too unclear.
Yeah, apparently after rook a8, it's not so clear. although he can take the pawn on h2 with the knight, come back, take the rook, but well, it's not as lost at least.
Some a lot of chances for white, yeah, practically.
Yeah.
Very open king and not so much time left.
Okay, knight f5, it's a funny situation because I only saw one move for white and it was knight e5. And Jan was thinking for almost an hour, so I was thinking what can be there. But knight e5 is also a very critical option.
Yeah, and what Anish played, I just completely.
Yeah, I was very lucky
to
find this the trick.
I almost expected him to take time. On a5 and then probably just gradually push the pawns and.
Yeah, well, it would be a desperate attempt, basically.
Yeah.
But somehow it seemed that I have miraculous. Escape here with the f3, because actually I was considering it, let's say here, and the point was that queen f3 was bad because of bishop b5 and knight f3 would win. So here I got the idea instantly because basically there is no knight takes f3. But the point is of course that knight c4 rook b4.
Yeah, and all the pawns start hanging. At first I was very happy because I saw rook e8 and if rook a5, rook b8, bishop b5, and my pawn.
Yeah, the pawns are going to roll. Well, it's sort of a tactic, which is...
Yeah, white can go for this tactic, yeah. But well, with an exchange down, and, well, the pawns would...
Yeah, the pawns are just too strong. So I should... But then I realized I have queen f5, and I realized I have the stronger move,
yeah.
Queen f4.
And here...
White
might even be better.
Well, at least it's not an option for black. It's clear. So knight c4 is the only move, I think. Because
yeah.
Queen f3, bishop b5 is the point. And then I think maybe line goes on, maybe not. Because I was at some point scared of this, but because if I take on c6, perhaps it's bad for white. But I think probably, because knight c6, queen b7, king d6. But I have check first. And that makes it good for white again.
If I try to run to
yeah,
left file,
in worst case, I would have won, yeah. Being the guy. So Jan took the bishop.
Now all my proud pawns are
one
by one.
Yeah, I was extremely happy to grab those. And first, I somehow misevaluated the position a little because I was thinking that here, if I take the knight, I'm worse. But then I realized it's sort of a fortress, and it seems that it's a dead draw, as people say. And otherwise, there's square b6, as Jan chose.
Yeah.
So
I just wanted to go to d5, defending.
Yeah, to try to... because now was my first intention, well, not intention, but first instinct was to take this one. But the king runs away, and the knight and queen are always very dangerous in those kind of positions with open king. But I luckily have queen e5, and I was even thinking I maybe am better.
Yeah, there's... the 33 rook c3,
yeah,
queen
that
takes
was
rook
very,
5 check.
Very happy.
I have to be a bit careful, because I want queen c7.
Yes.
And here I offered the draw.
Yeah, it was...
In the worst case, white can simply take rook c4 and rook takes c3, which...
Yeah, and if talking about white taking over, I think... Well, because I have a lot of pawns,
yeah,
I think it's not likely, because h4, bishop a6, and probably I still have to take...
Yeah.
Take the pawn. Although I can try to play risky, I'll put the rook somewhere here.
Yeah, then we.
But then we will play, and I already played enough. Jan probably not, but I did.
Okay,
so. And in view of this rook c3 idea, we agreed to draw.